confirm together that our intent is to be fully present to the spirit that dwells within each of us, allowing our thoughts to be directed by the divine presence within. We commit ourselves to the truth that we are loved and loving, valuable and worthy of all the gifts of spirit. In this awareness, we open to our own highest power, and we are grateful. And so it is. So today's ceremony is a three-part ceremony. First, we'll review the past for any events, feelings, or beliefs that we wish to release. Then, we'll review the past year for events, feelings, and beliefs that we wish to hold on to as we go forward into our new year. And then the third and last part of the ceremony is about setting intentions for the new year, affirming for ourselves who we wish to be, how we want to show up in the world, and maybe making commitments to ourselves as to what we want to do. And certainly making an invitation to the divine to be more fully known in and through us. So, let's get started. I want to begin, each stage will begin with meditation. I want to invite you into this time of meditation by relaxing, closing your eyes if that's comfortable. And if not, finding a focal point upon which your eyes might be focused. Relax in your seat, resting deeply into the space beneath you. Become aware of your body and breath. You are surrounded by love, imbued with love. You are love itself.
cleaning up ego stuff is called purification. Purification is the act of letting go. This is done out of discriminative awareness. That is, you understand that you are an entity passing through a life in which the entire wrong is an offering for your awakening. Thank you, Mom God. Please allow these words to be your own. I let spirit heal every new me now. I trust that these situations have been for the highest and best. I bless every challenging experience of my past year, knowing that these have brought more meaning into my life. That being said, I am grateful to have this opportunity to release that with which I am complete. I invite you to breathe deeply and release as you feel ready. So each of you has received two pieces of paper, and I want to invite you to put one piece of paper aside for now. And on the first piece, I invite you to write a letter to yourself, to God, to your highest self, to the divine within, whatever is your best method for speaking to the highest, holiest experience of being known. And release, naming those things that you release. When you're complete with that letter, I invite you to come and bring it here, place it in this bowl. We're going to have a few minutes for you to just write, and then Janine will be playing music. After the service today, but after service today, we will immediately take this bowl out to the courtyard out there and transfer them to another bowl that's been lined with foil, and we will burn them. Fire is part of the purification process. It's been known as such from the earliest time. So we engage in this. Let the belly be soft. are living a life of prosperity, creativity, love, and joy. 2019 has been abundant in amazing experiences, dramatic growth, and an increasing awareness of spirit in our lives. I invite you to let your mind wander over the past year and show you these fabulous, wonderful events that have blessed you for the past 12 months. As these beautiful memories come to mind, let a smile cross your face. Thoroughly enjoy reliving these days of joy. We'll move into the silence now for each of us to spend a few moments with these memories. Celebration, joy, gratitude. There's much to be grateful for. Our lives are rich with meaning, overflowing with love. From the 14th century Sufi poet Rumi, be grateful for your life, every detail of it. And your face will come to shine like a sun, and everyone who sees it will be made glad and peaceful. We are grateful. Thank you, God. Join me.
Thank you, God.
Again?
Thank you, God.
We're grateful for the abundant blessings that we've received in this past year. If you haven't already, I invite you to return your attention to this room, to this time, to this space. Open your eyes, wiggle your fingers and your toes. Yep, let's turn on the lights. So you should have another piece of paper and an envelope. At the top of the page, write, thank you God, or thank you Spirit, or thank you Highest God. Power or whatever the word is that represents your experience of God. And then fill in the blank. List the things in 2019 that are celebrated, that you are willing to say, thank you, God, thank you, universe, thank you, Spirit. Now, my request is that you try to just do one side of that page. If you have so much to celebrate that you're going over to the other side, good job. Great job. And we want to use the other side for the third part of our ritual. So, scribble in the margins, whatever you need to do.
I'm so grateful for all that I have. I'm so grateful.
final days of meditation now. Relaxing your bodies and minds again, closing the eyes again, resting deeply into your space. Focus your attention on the breath as it flows in and out of your nostrils. Feel your chest, your stomach rise and fall. Allow your heart and mind to be led by the breath of spirit. We are blessed. So blessed. With friendships, love, Spirit, I am ready to do those things that are to be done by me. I trust the door is open. From the Tao Te Ching, put things in order before they exist. The giant pine tree grows from a tiny seed. The journey of 1,000 miles starts from beneath your feet. I am ready. It is thinking the thought that is the seed waiting for the nourishment of action. We have only to begin. So breathing deeply. I invite you to bring your attention back to this room, this time, and this place. To open your eyes. Lights, please. So, on the other side of that sheet where you've written your list of many celebrations of gratitudes throughout 2019, you can write a letter of intention for 2020. Again, you address it however your soul, your heart, your mind feel the most connected. And then, whatever the intentions are for the year, go ahead and write that little letter as a love letter to yourself. Represent you, us as a whole, because it's been 7 years since the last time, or 6 years since the last time we did this mission, vision, and values work, and to determine where we were going as a community. But you're here now, and you might have changed since the last time we did it. And so, please plan on the first Sunday in February, first Saturday in February, participating in that summit. And finding out what our results from that are. Other stuff that we did.
Well, we installed Audrey Pitchford as our licensed Unity teacher.
We had the pleasure of a variety of amazing music during the first two-thirds of the year, with Ted Clark being our music minister, and then welcoming Janine. Groups program served about 50 people in our community through two 10-week sessions, which meant that 50 people became closer, more connected, and actually have real relationships, friendships in this community. Also, we continue to serve outside nonprofit organizations, Thurston County Mediation, Providence Hospital, Kids Care Grief Group, AA, ACA. There's other A's to come. Don't you worry. We did concerts, We did picnics. We did classes in meditation and prayer, five principles, embracing the divine feminine. We did a fundraiser last March. Anybody remember the murder mystery dinner party and auction? And we said goodbye to some very, very dear friends. This 2019, we said goodbye to Jim Vetter, Audrey Higby, Jim Kiefert, Bonnie Carroll, and Ruth Gregory. And we bless them, we release them, and we honor them by taking with us the great love that they shared with us in every moment that they were part of Unity of Olympia. In 2020, we look forward to completing our appreciative inquiry process by taking a look at our mission, vision, and values. We look forward to a new strategic plan. Ours has been expired for a year now. We look forward to a 30-day well-being challenge that you'll be learning more and more about as we get closer to the launch, which will be followed up by a Valentine's Day dinner. Sorry, no murders happening at this dinner, Valentine's Day. And one thing of note that I and the staff here at Unity of Olympia are so grateful for is that we are going to have a policy manual for this organization by the annual meeting, which I know sounds dry and boring, but it's not. It's like at the top of the list for me about exciting things that are going to happen this year. A real policy manual for our community. So these are the things we look forward to. Oh, and one last very exciting thing that happened in 2019. When we began January 1st of 2019, we had a debt of $79,399.09. To date, as of the end of November 2019, we owe $25,000. Because of your generosity, that's a difference of $54,200. That's pretty great for a year when we didn't actually ask for money. Well, I mean, we're always asking for money, but so, good job. Thank you. Let's close. I'm going to assume that everybody's done with their letters now. Let's close with prayer. As we join in prayer, we're grateful for this time together and for the intimacy that is created through this sacred ceremony. We affirm that we have released that which no longer serves us as we go forward into 2020. We honor the valuable lessons of the past year. We celebrate the many events and relationships that have blessed us in 2019. We commit to being the people we are led to be by the urging voice of spirit that lives within each of us. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Together.
Thank you, God.
So it is.
Who you are, you can show the world just who you are.